This guy had some marital problems, not marital bliss, so he turned to cannibalism. I don't know. Who knows why, but... Well, that's what this movie says. This movie says that this gentleman turned to cannibalism, and I don't know exactly why, but it's just something that happened. So, you know. So what does that mean? What does that mean?
But February made me shiver. With every paper I deliver, bad news on the doorstep. I couldn't take one more step. I can't remember.
What does it mean when a man has marital troubles, so he finally, after 30 years, turns to cannibalism? I don't know. Does it mean... you become a High Plains drifter? I don't know. Or does it mean you turn to hymns? It depends. Wouldn't it depend? I mean, some men end up in jail because they were framed for turning to cannibalism and eating their wives. And some men actually do it for real. Okay, so let's listen to what he has to say.
You look like you need a friend, and I'm a very helpful guy. Come on, what do you say, huh?
I heard you were a leg man, not a breast man. That tickles. When are we going to eat?
Soon, I hope. But the meat first has to be prepared.
So? Shouldn't you be doing it?
I thought I was. Ooh, what a great deal. I never had so much clock for a... I really don't know where to begin, Doc. I've always been sort of a normal fella, you know, just an ordinary Joe. It's true I haven't had sex in about 50 years, but there's a lot of that going around. My wife used to say I was insane because I wouldn't eat anything I couldn't pronounce. When I get really bored, I like to drive around and see how many squashed dogs I can count on the freeways.
So, he likes to drive around in his car and see how many roadkill have occurred. But he doesn't say that he approves of it. He just says that he's accepted the fact that people drive cars because they like to kill small, furry animals on the road.
Kind of that makes me crazy, does it? But there have been a lot of changes in me since May left. I mean, I never had it so good. I eat what I want. And I've been screwing some really nice people. But the thing is, the two things are one and the same. Sure, I'm happy to be sexually active again. But I think there's something unusual about what turns me on. Honey, I just had a talk to somebody about it. I thought I'd see my priest and confess, but he does everything by the book. And I don't think he can look this one up. You see, women didn't excite me until I started to, well... I couldn't make it with them. Unless I imagine, let's say, consuming them afterwards. Other guys complain about having to take a girl home for dinner, then screwing her. Well, I have to have her for dinner after I screw her.
There. It's out. I feel so much better. Gee, it's great to have finally someone to tell it to.
They caught the last train for the coast today. The music died, and they were singing.
Good night, sweetheart, when it's time to go.
Thanks, Doc. Hey, Doc. Doc. Oh, yes, yes. Yes, I heard nothing. It sounded irregular. What seems to be the problem?
Well, the problem is I can't make love to a woman unless I eat her.
Why not? This is the age of liberation, a time of romantic sophistication. And if it helps you achieve a higher plateau of stimulation, by the great Gatsby, go down on her!
But you don't understand, Doc. I must do hideous things to her.
Oh, nonsense. Nonsense. There's nothing hideous about compatible love. If it feels good, man, just do it. Do it.
You're sure?
Of course. She'll be grateful. She'll lose her head over you. And she'll satiate your appetite. And she'll give and give of herself until there's nothing left to give.
Wow. Gee, thanks, Doc.
So that's the story of something that happened in what, this city here, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania? I don't know. I heard it on the news one time, but nevertheless, you really have to take into focus the fact that Jackie Vernon was a child actor at one time. So, I mean, why did he do a movie like this? You see what I'm saying? It's a little bit confusing. So, but nevertheless, still, you got to take it into fact and not fiction, right? So, anyways, that's the story of Jackie Vernon and the Microwave Massacre. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, sometimes you wonder about
this. I met a girl who sang the blues, and I asked her for some happy news. And she just smiled and turned away. I went down to the sacred store where I'd heard the music years before. But the man there said
the music wouldn't play.
And in the streets the children screamed. The
lovers cried and the poets dreamed.
But
not a word was spoken.
The church bells all were broken. And the three men I admired most. The father, son,
for the coast, the day the music died. All right, so the story of Microwave Massacre, starring Jackie Vernon. Okay, well, there you go. So what do you know?